Hello students, good morning everyone. So in our previous class we have started unit 3. So under unit 3 we have started the first chapter, that is demand analysis. So the analysis of the demand is basically into two aspects. We have studied the introduction and the different definitions under the demand analysis, like the demand, supply, demand function and supply function. So the requirement, the desire for the requirement of an item or a product is called the demand, and the availability of that product is called the supply within the given price. So there will be various factors which will be influencing the demand and supply. So the factors, so if you write the functional relationship between demand or supply in terms of the other factors which influence the demand or supply, like the price or the income or the prices of other commodities, so all these together, if you write the functional relationship, then these are called the demand and supply functions. So we have seen the demand curve and the supply curves, and also the equilibrium price. So the price at which the demand and the supply curves intersect, that is called the equilibrium price. The solution for equilibrium price is D equals to S. That is, demand curve is denoted with D and supply curve is denoted with S, right? So D equals to S is the solution for the equilibrium price. So whenever they ask to find the equilibrium price, you will be finding the solution D equals to S, and we you will estimate the P value. So in today's class we will move on with the next definition. The next definition is price elasticity of demand.
Whereas if you compare the luxury items, if you see the
the gold rates or the silver rates, the price is increasing to the high. At the same time, the demand decreases also high, not very less, because it is not our necessary good. So sometimes it depends on which type of good the demand depends on the which type of good it is. So always the price will be affecting differently demand for the different commodities. So here I am assuming that let X be the quantity demand for any commodity. So let X be the quantity demand for any commodity. So first I am assuming the quantity, that is X be the quantity demanded for any commodity such that the demand function is given as. So I am writing the demand function. The demand function is given as. So I am writing the demand function as X equals to F of P. So I am writing in terms of price only, right? So X equals to F of P be the demand function. Now let the increment in the demand, and we have to write that the small change in demand, small change in price. So what are the changes we will write now? So now let the increment in demand be dou t. Let increment in demand for any particular commodity. So the increment in demand is denoted with dou. Sorry, the increment in the demand for the commodity to the increment in the price. So let the increment in the demand to the increment in the price, to the increment in the price. So the increment in price is denoted as delta P is delta X. So what does it mean is a delta P change. Delta P is the price which is increased or decreased. We are writing here increment, and the demand in the increment is denoted with delta X, that is dou X, because we are writing the function, the quantity as X. So that's why we will be writing delta X is the demand, increment in the demand. Delta P is the increment in the price. So by the definition, so this price elasticity of demand, it is denoted with eta P. It is denoted with the symbol eta P, and is equals to, what is the definition? The ratio of, that means first the denominator, relative change in demand divided by relative change in supply. So this is according to the definition. So what is the relative change in the demand? So generally you have written the increment. So if you want to find the change, what you will do? We will find the relative change is given as, it is the increment among what is the quantity? X. So dou X by X will be the relative change in demand. Eta P equals to dou X by X is the relative change. So we assume the capital X here, right? So we will be writing capital X only. Also dou X by X, that is the relative change in demand divided by relative change in price. Sorry, I am written in supply here. Relative change in price. So what is the relative change in price? The increment is delta P, and the price is generally denoted with P. So how can you write this one? So if I write the I will be sending the denominator to numerator. so that what I'll get, so this p will become the numerator, right? So first you'll get p by x, eta p equals to p by x into, you will be having delta x by delta p. So this is the eta p value, that is delta x by delta p. So this can be written as eta p equals to minus p by, so write it down after this, minus p by x into dou y dou p of x, that is the partial differentiation. Now you can write dou y dou p of x, but what we are writing minus, since we are finding the demand with respect to the price. If you observe, demand and supply always move in the opposite direction. That means if price increases, demand decreases, and if price decreases, the demand increases. So since price and demand move in opposite direction, minus sign is taken. So this is the reason for taking the minus sign. So this can be simply written as, if you apply the limit. So just by applying the limit, so applying limit means the eta p will be eta p only. Just the small differentiation. This is what the small increment. The differentiation, that is minus p by x into d by dp of x. That means, suppose if you, the demand function curve is given. X is the demand curve, right? X equals to f of p. So, if the demand curve is given, if you differentiate it and apply minus p by x into this, you will be getting the eta p value. So, what does this eta p indicates means? If there is 1% change in price, if there is 1% change in price, so price is denoted with P, so if 1% of P changes, then there will be eta P percent change in demand. So if 1% price changes, the eta p percent, the demand changes. So this is about the price elasticity of demand. Next we will be studying about the demand function with constant price elasticity. Now coming to the demand function with constant price elasticity. So we know the, what is price elasticity? That means the small change in price, how much the change will be in the demand. And we are finding demand function with constant price elasticity. That means there will be a constant change in the price. So if the price changes constantly, what is the demand function we will be seeing now? So suppose let x be the demand function. So always assume x as the demand function. Let x be the demand function. So I am assuming x be the demand function, and we also have the price elasticity of demand, right? So the price elasticity of demand. So what is the price elasticity of demand denoted with eta p? So price elasticity of demand eta p equals to some constant I have to write, because we are finding the demand function with constant price elasticity. So that is eta p equals to, I am writing alpha as the constant. That means what is the demand function? X. So I have to find the x value. So for this purpose, we have to first differentiate. Here we have divide dt of x. So first differentiate it. So what is the differentiation of x? X is 1 by x. So we are doing differentiation with respect to x. So we will be writing dx. 1 by x into dx equals to alpha. So here alpha is the constant, right? So alpha is the constant value and, first we will shift the items. First we will be shifting all the x terms I will be writing one side and p terms I will write one side. So first I am writing 1 by x dx, here I am writing as it is, equals to, here we have minus p. If minus p goes that side, it will be minus 1 by p. This is dp dividing, if it goes that side, it will become into dp into alpha. So this is the value we have written. So for this, first we will be doing the integration. So to find the x value, first I will be doing the integrate on both sides. Integrate on both sides. So that is integral 1 by x dx equals to minus of, even alpha is constant, right? So minus alpha you write outside, integral of 1 by p dp. So you are just integrating here. And what is 1 by x integration? 1 by x integration is log x. So here you will get log x equals to minus alpha is constant. And what is the integration of 1 by p? 1 by p is log p. Minus alpha log p. And you will be writing some constant also, that is log c. So always for integration we will write one constant, right? In our differentiation and integration, one constant. So here I am writing log c. So this can be written as, here log, I have to find x value, right? So first write down log x equals to, here we have minus alpha log p, which can be written as log p power minus alpha. This is in the form of m log a, I am writing as log a power m plus log c. So this is in the form of log a plus log b. I can write together log a into b. So therefore log x equals to log of p power minus alpha into c. So both the sides of log, if I remove the log, I will be getting the demand function x as x equals to c p power minus alpha. So this is the demand function with constant price elasticity, that is x equals to cp power minus alpha. Next we will see a small problem related to demand function with constant price elasticity. So coming to the question, it is given, the demand function is given as, the demand function we will be writing with x equals to, that is x equals to 10 minus p. So we need to find the price elasticity of demand at a particular price, that is p equals to 6. And also if the price increases by 5%, then find the change in the percentage of the demand. So here we will be using the price elasticity of demand formula. So first write down the given demand function. Is x equals to 10 minus p. So what is the price elasticity of demand? It is denoted with eta p. So eta p equals to minus p by x into d by d by dp of x. Now substituting x value, we will be getting the theta p value. Theta p equals to minus p by, what is the x value? 10 minus p into d by dp of 10 minus p. So now we have to differentiate this 10 minus p with respect to p. So we will be getting theta p equals to minus p by 10 minus p as it is into our total differentiation. Differentiation of 10 is 0 minus differentiation of 1 is minus 1. So p minus p into minus 1 is plus p. So therefore theta p value equals to p by 10 minus p. So what they have asked, find the price elasticity of demand at p equals to 6. So at p equals to 6, theta p equals to, substitute the value 6 by 10 minus 6, that is 6 by 4, that is 3 by 2. So therefore theta p equals to 3 by 2. So that means if there is 1% change in price, 3 by 2% of will be change will be there for the in the demand. Now what they have asked here, we have to find the if the increase in is 5%. So say 3 by 2 can be written as 1.5, right? So therefore we write it as theta p equals to 1.5. So if 1% price increases, theta p percent demand changes. demand, we took the minus sign because the both price and demand move in the opposite direction. But coming to price and supply, both have a positive relationship. If price increases, the supply also increases. If the price decreases, the supply also decreases. So we will be taking the plus sign only. Now we will see supply curve for a constant price elasticity. Supply curve for the constant price elasticity. So the similar way how we got the demand curve for the constant price elasticity, here also we are going to find the supply curve for the constant price elasticity. So how we will be writing the constant means epsilon p equals to alpha, where alpha is the constant. Now what is epsilon p value? P by x, d by dt, we can write ds by dp equals to alpha. Now write all p terms one side and s terms one side. So here we have said I am writing the s terms. 1 by s into ds equals to 1 by p into dp into alpha. Now integrate on both sides. Integrate on both sides. So what will be getting? Integral 1 by s ds equals to alpha is constant, integral 1 by p dp. So 1 by s integration is log s equals to alpha into 1 by p integration is log p plus some constant log c. So in the similar way, this we can write it as log p over alpha plus log c. Now log s is equals to log of p over alpha into c. So therefore s equals to c p over alpha is the supply function with constant price elasticity. So in demand function you will get c p power minus alpha because there will be an opposite direction, and for supply function you will be getting s equals to c p power alpha. Now we'll see a problem on the supply function, that means price elasticity of supply. Coming to the question, the supply curve is given as s equals to a into under root p minus p, where p is the price and a comma b are the constants, and price is always greater than b. So find the price elasticity of supply at the price p equals to 2b. Now the given supply curve is s equals to a into under root p minus p, and write down the price elasticity of supply formula, that is epsilon p equals to p by s into p by dp of s, right? D by dp of s. Now substitute the s value. Epsilon p equals to p by s value is a into under root p minus p into d by dp of a into under root p minus b. So here p by a into root p minus b into a is constant into root p minus b. So what is the differentiation of root x? That is 1 by 2 root x. 1 by 2 root x, that is 1 by under root p minus b. Now this is all about the today's class. In the next class, we will be starting the some methods for fitting the demand function.